Hello guys, welcome back to Tech Institute. Now let's see what is interface in TypeScript. So basically interface is a collection of the properties, methods and events which are the members of the interface, and interface contains only the declaration of the members. That means we can only declare the methods, properties and events inside the interfaces. And those properties, methods and events have to implement or you have to use it inside the class. So it is a responsibility of the deriving class to define the members, that means the properties, methods and events of an interface. So basically interface gives you the set of rules which or it should be implemented by the class. So it often helps in providing the standard structure that the deriving class would follow. Okay, so it is a set of rules which is given by the interface and that have to follow inside the class. Okay, now for example, look the first example in a TypeScript interface is used in a variety of types. So first is the interface in objects. Now look here. So interface iPerson is declared with interfaces keyword. This is the name of the interface. Now curly bracket start here, curly bracket end. The first name colon string. So this is the field. Last name colon string. It is also field. It is a type of string. This is a method. Say hi colon, and this is a rounded bracket. The arrow operator is used, and the return type of the say hello is a string. So in this way also you can define it. Now I want to assign this iPerson object directly, interface object. If I want to assign in TypeScript, allows you to assign the iPerson object, that is interface object. Now how to do this? Look here, variable customer is my variable name, and then the type of customer is iPerson. And now if I want to assign iPerson, then equal to here body starts. And now first name is equal to value, last name is equal to value, and the function that is having a definition return hi there. So basically this is an anonymous object. Okay, this is a object created directly with the help of the interface. There is no class, it's an anonymous class, correct? And it is assigned to one variable customer. So now customer having an object of an interface. Okay, so using this object you can iterate the values of Tom and Hanks, etc. So this is the interface and objects. Now just how to get a value from the customer, look here. So customer object, just console.log customer.firstname. If I print here, so it will print the first name. Customer.lastname, then it will print the last name. Then I call a method say hi, so it returns you hi there. Okay, so using customer variable you can iterate the value from the interface object. Okay, now second example, employee. Again the employee is a type of iPerson, and then first name colon Jean, then last name colon Blex. This is the value for the fields of the interface, and then again the body for the method say hi, it returns you the hello. And then it is ended. Now console.log employee objects get printed, employee.firstname, employee.lastname, and your, if you want to give a call to the say hi, here you write console.log employee.say hi. Okay, this is second example of interface and object. Now just see the next, interfaces and array. So it is little bit different. So interfaces can be defined both kind of key and array uses, and the type of entry it contains. Okay, so the key you can define for an array using interface. Interface key is known as an index. Index can be type of string or number. So index you can define about type string or number. This is possible. So look here. So interface now declared with a name list. Okay, and here curly bracket start. Now the index for the name list is a number, and the value which you want to store into the name list is a string. So it is an array of a name list. Okay, now you are defining the rule that is a index should contain number and the value should contain a string. Now look here, how to iterate it. So variable list2 is of a type name list is equal to John comma 1 comma Brian. Now name list index should be number, but the value should be string. Now here John is a string, correct? But it is an integer, it is a number, so it is an error. And this is also string. So these two values are valid, but this is not a valid value. That's why it gives error. One is not a type of string. So we have to modify this. Okay. So suppose another example, interface ages. Now here index is a type of string, and now the value is of type of number. Now how to give a value? So age list. I define age list of a type ages, and here age list of John is equal to 15. Now index is a number, correct? Sorry, index is a string, and here value is number, so it is okay. So if I try to store a number and it is a string, then it gives you error. So interfaces and arrays, this combination is also possible in a TypeScript. A little bit in a TypeScript, it is more flexible how to use an interface. The various combinations are available with the help of the variables, with the help of the object variables, with the help of the array, with the help of the function, and then with the help of n class. So in most of the traditional programming language, we know how to use the interface in n class using implements, okay? But here we can use with the various combinations, with the help of object, with the help of array, etc., etc. Now look the interfaces and inheritance. So an interface can be extended by the other interfaces. So one interface can extend to the another interface, and other words, the interface can inherit from the other interfaces. The TypeScript allows you an interface to inherit from the multiple interfaces. This is also possible. So multiple interface, that is a super type, and then the single subtype may be the another interface. And for the class also, we can use the interface just to implement that interface. Okay. Now simple inheritance, just look at the interface I person of a type string, gender of a type string, and then here look here interface I employee, another interface extends the I person. Now employee code is equal to number. Now how many data members for an I employee? First is employee code, and then name and gender, which is coming from the super type. Okay, and then how to create an object of an interface? Look at I employee is equal to curly bracket star, employee code is equal to 1, name is equal to bill, gender is equal to male. Now to print it, employee console.log employee object dot employee code, employee object dot name, employee object dot gender. So this this object gets created with the help of I employee object, but I employee object is already inherited from the I person. That's why we can take help of the name and gender into the I employee, and here employee object is a type of I employee. So that's why this are the valid example of simple inheritance. Now look the example for the class, how to go with the class implements and interface. So interface I person, now again a name of string, it is a variable. A display is a method, return type is void. This is another interface. Now employee code is again a number. Now here look here, this is not extended to the employee. Now both are individual interfaces, and for class employee implements I person comma I employee, and then now employee code is equal to number, name is equal to string, these data members are defined, and here it is assigned, and the display method is given, and here it is printing this dot name and this dot employee. Okay, now look here, the objects get created. Let the variable person is equal to I person is equal to new employee 100 and bill, and then I call a person object dot display. Now display gets called, and whatever the name and employee code are available, it gets printed, correct? Yes or no? Okay, now here another object is created, let employee colon is equal to I employee is equal to new employee 100 comma bill. But here employee dot display, when I give a call, compiler gives an error because display is not available into the I employee, it is available into the I person. And why it is gives you error? Look here, this type, the reference variable is a type of super type, and the object is of a subtype. It is known as the upcasting. In upcasting, always remember when you do the upcasting and when you call a particular method, that method should be present in a super type as well as a subtype. So at least declaration should be present. So it should be method overriding. Then only you can give a call to the per dot display. Otherwise, it gives you error. And that's why here is error. I employee display is not available into the employee. And here you are overriding, but this is an upcasting, so it gives you straightforward error. How to resolve it? You simply remove the upcasting, create a simple object of employee, and then give a call to the display. It gives you the proper output. Okay. So this is about the simple class and interface. So up till now, what we have seen is just go through the previous slides. So the interface, what is interface? It is a set of rules. Then interface and objects. Then we have seen the another example of interface and objects. Then array and interfaces. So it is a little bit different. And then we have seen the interfaces and inheritance. So simple inheritance, interface to interface, and then class to interface, that is implements. Okay. So if you have any doubt, you can make a comment in the comment box. Now next type is the interface as a function type. Now this is again a little bit different. TypeScript interface is also used to define the type of functions. So this ensures the function signature. So look the example, interface key value processor. So this is having the structure, key is a number and value is a string, and type of that function is the void. Okay. Now look here, if I define a function add key value and key colon is a number, value is a string, colon void, and here console.log the key and value I am printing. Another function I declared is a update key value of the same type, and here look here the variable is declared key value pair and key value processor, this is the name of the interface, and here what I am assigning add key value. Okay, so here I am assigning add key value as a function. So I am assigning function to the interface. Are you getting? So this is, I am assigning function to the interface. Now when I call kvp1, bill, whatever output is there, so this function gets called. Are you getting? Next, kvp updates key value. So I am assigning now kvp is equal to update key value. I am assigning second function. Then I can give a call to the kvp2, stew. So output is update key value, key is equal to 2 and value is equal to 2. So why we are doing this? So simply we are assigning function to the interface, and that's why both function should follow the method signature which is given in interface. Look in interface, in the previous slide, the method signature is given key, number, value, string, and return type void. And here also the same thing, add key value, the parameter type is a key, is a number, value is a string, and here the return type is a void. Are you getting? So method signature, that is a rule we are assigning to the methods with the help of interface. That's why we are assigning function type as a interface. Let's see what is a duck typing in a TypeScript. So according to the TypeScript, duck typing is the method or rule used to check the type compatibility for more complex variable types. So the TypeScript uses a duck typing method to compare one or more objects, one object with another objects by checking that both objects have the same type matching names or not. So in an interface also, it's a complex object, and there when we want to assign a value to a respective type, there in a previous example the compatibility is checked. For example, interface to the function, so when the method signature is given in interface, so at that time when we call that function, so we have to follow the method signature what is assigned to that function, correct? So it means we cannot change the signature of the variable or the methods or functions For example, if we assign an object that has two properties like a name and address, and next time we assign an object which contains more properties or fewer properties, or both properties are not, then TypeScript compiler will generate a compile time error. So obviously type compatibility is checked. This concept is known as a duck typing. It is very powerful feature. Duck typing feature provides the type safety in a TypeScript code. So for example, we just take another example. So union type and interface. Look here, the interface I defined a program string, command line string, array, the pipe or string or pipe symbol, and it is a function. So look here in a first variable option of a type run option, and the values are test, it is a string, and command line is a string. So command line is a type of string, array or string or function. But it is a first is a string, so it is applicable, so it is a valid one. Second option program test, yes, it is a string command line. Now it is a square bracket hello comma world, so it is first string, second string, it is a string array, and command line takes the string array, yes, it is applicable, so it is applicable. So here it is a duck typing, correct? Yes. So there are a lot of example in interface. The duck typing is used. So union type, the functions, function and interface, object and interface. Okay. So if you have any doubt, you just make a comment in a comment box. Thank you.